Hi friends, this is Anita Kejriwal from Dress My Craft. Today I have a tutorial for making a DIY gift bag, a matching gardener tag made with the Magical Unicorns paper pad. This paper pad was recently launched and it's a beautiful, cute paper pad that you'll instantly fall in love with. Let me show you some prints inside. Aren't they beautiful? Look at these cute different images of the unicorns and these shabby chic pink papers which really go all along with the whole theme. Here are the pre-cut die cuts. Now that's a boon for crafters. No more fussy cutting. They all are beautifully pre-cut. And we also have a 6x6 paper pad for that as well. Now let's begin making the bag. For this, I have two papers cut from the 12x12 inch paper pad. That is 8.5 inches and 8 inches. And I'll be using the Dress My Craft scoring board for this. You see on the scoring board, the measurements are given as 1/2, 1/4, 3/4, which makes reading them so easy. And now I'll be placing one of the papers on the scoring board and marking it at the 1/2 inch score line. Repeat that for the other paper as well. Keep the longer side on top and then rotate the paper and make 1 inch marks on the rest of the 3 sides. So repeat that for the other paper as well. That is how we will do 3 inches. That is 1 inch, 3 sides. You will have the 1 inch mark. And 1 side will be 1/2 inch mark. Now fold the paper very well, burnishing them very well with the bone folder. This is very important to make the bag really look nice and neat with crisp folds. So here I'm just folding the 1 inch sides with the bone folder. Now what I'll do is I'll cut, make a slit on the bottom of one of the sides. This is like creating a flap so that the edges come together to form a lid like box, but for the 2 sides. Here I'm making a flap and I'll be securing it with red tacky tape. But before that, I will have to apply tacky tape on the top where we had made the 1/2 inch score line, and then folding it and securing it very well. Now I'll be applying tacky tape. Now you must be noticing that I'm using tacky tape and not wet adhesive, because I want my bag to be really neat and secured very well. But if I use wet adhesive, there are chances that my bag will open up. So I prefer using red tacky tape for these projects which are specially 3D in nature. So just apply tacky tape, which is strong and nice adhesive and will not open your bag. And here I'm just now putting the bags together, the 2 sides of the bags together, actually one inside the other, holding them firmly and pressing it well so that they fit inside each other very well. Now put tacky tape on the 3 sides, that is on the 1 inch side, the 2 sides and the bottom, here like this. But that you will do only for one of the sides of the box and not on both the sides. Just apply tacky tape on the sides and the bottom of one of the boxes. So here I'm just doing that. Tacky tape is a very strong adhesive. Again, I'm repeating, please do not use wet adhesive for this. This is because wet adhesive tends to make the bag not very strongly secured, and it might open up when you'll put your object inside this. But tacky tape is a very strong adhesive and it really helps to stay the bag together. So now I'm just removing the backing paper from the tacky tape. Just remove one of the sides before you put in the other side together. And here I'm just fitting the 2 sides together very nicely and firmly inside it. You see how beautifully they fit inside each other, and it is so easy to make this bag. You can make any size bag. If you want a 6x6 inch bag or even a 12x12 inch bag, for that you'll need a 12x12 inch paper, and just do follow the measurements of 1 inch around and 1/2 inch on the top, and you will get a bag which is bigger in size. Now let's do some decoration. To do some finishing for the edges, I have cut 2 strips of paper from the same paper pad. Just making 2 score lines on these at 3/4 inch and at the next score line, and then I'll be folding them together like so. I'm just giving a little corner of rounding with the rounding corner punch, and then I am just adding these together. For this you can use a wet adhesive, but here again I prefer to use the tacky tape as well. As you see, tacky tape gives a very nice, neat and finished project, so refrain from using the adhesive except the red tacky tape. So here you see it gives a very nice edge and the box stands very nice and firm. Now I'll be doing some decoration for the box. I'll be doing the decoration for the bag. Now for this I've taken a pink strip of paper and I'm adding some lace. This is the Cherry Lynn doily lace. I'm using Tombow adhesive. Now you can use your wet adhesive. This is what it looks like. I'm adding some patterned paper on top. And this too I'm applying with the Tombow glue. You can use any type of decoration you want. This is what I'm doing. It's just very quick and simple, but it really looks gorgeous. The papers itself are so gorgeous that one really does not need to do much decoration, but I thought of just embellishing them. So here I've just applied some double-sided tape and have put the that paper strip that I just decorated and created. Now I'm putting two doilies together. These are two doily die cuts from my stash. Again, I'm using double-sided tape to mount these on the front of the bag. I have used two strips of paper, that is the two strips of paper cut from the paper pad, and have punched them using the banner punch. Then I have taken circle frame. I have some stitched circle frame. I'm just adding four of them together to add some dimension. This way you can add a dimension to any die cut by adding two or three of them together, and it really pops up the die cut very well. Now I've added some vellum paper at the back of these frames. Now one tip for this is, when you're using vellum paper, please use Tombow glue and no other glue except the Tombow glue, because that is the only glue which helps the vellum to stay together. All the other glues which you will use will curl up the vellum. The 180 GSM vellum by Dress My Craft is a super paper, and you can use it for any purpose. Here I'm using it as a backing for my frame. Now I will be adding some flower pearls in this. So let me get some flower pearls. I have some pink flower pearls and some purple flower pearls, and these are really coordinating with the paper very well. So let me put some glue. Again, as you see, I'm just using Tombow glue and no other glue here, because that will prevent my paper, that is the vellum paper, from curling. So I'm applying some, adding some pink and some beautiful purple flower pearls. These are gorgeous and help you to create really nice embellishments. Just remove the excess. And then what should we do next? Let's see. I have some flowers, as you see on my table. These are mulberry flowers, and I'll be adding them because mulberry flowers really add beautiful, beautiful look to the project. So for quick and easy projects, you can use mulberry flowers, and we have a wide variety of them in the Dress My Craft store. So I'm using the little peachish pink color and some shaded pink color. I'm using the hot glue to add these. Now I'm adding some more. Here two of them goes here. So this is a lovely way of creating boxes or gift bags. And now I am using the die cuts. How easy it is to use these die cuts. No more fussy cutting. These are, and they come in, I think, three together for the same design. And they're just awesome. So isn't this lovely? Just see how quickly you could add those and create a beautiful design. Some leaves here and there. And now I'll be making some hole with my crocodile at the side, so that I can string in some ribbon for a handle. So here I have already got my ribbon together. That is a bunch of purple and white ribbons. And here I've strung the strings together, the ribbons together, to the holes that I made on the side. Now let me add some more things to that. Here are some fashion accessories. These are beautiful. I think they are not fashion accessories. I'm so sorry. These are bubblegum accessories which come on the store. and I'm just adding as a dangler on the side. There's a hangings on the side. So that's my bag that's ready. And I have made a matching card and a matching tag with it. For the tag, I've using the rounded tag punch. And in the similar way, I've used some confetti, sparkling powder, and that's the card I have made. Now, this is a really beautiful, beautiful way of giving gifts to anyone, and it's really easy to create these. I hope you liked my tutorial. Do visit the store for all your craft supplies, and thanks for watching.